Joseph Murray is most well known for performing the first successful whole organ transplant in 1954. Joseph Murray went to Harvard Medical School and was a plastic surgeon and a reconstructive surgeon and a transplant surgeon. He is recruited by the Brigham and recruited by two physicians, George Thorne and Francis Moore, who are actively engaging in this idea of, can you have a successful whole organ transplant? And so they're doing some of this preliminary work and they're trying to sort of get to this point where they think it could happen, but they still have no answer for tissue rejection. And it's sort of one of these serendipitous moments that happen in the history of medicine. Two brothers are actually referred to them because they're identical twins. The thinking was that the only way that they would be able to achieve whole organ transplant successfully without rejection is if you had identical genetic people. And it was a sort of complete success. The donor lived a very full life, over 50 years. And the recipient, Richard, lived for 8 years and married and had children. It becomes such a singular celebrated moment and opens this door to this idea of successful organ transplant. And that allows them to start to really think about, are there other ways to control tissue rejection so that we can enter a space where we don't need identical twins? Joseph Murray wins the Nobel Prize. By that point, he was no longer actively involved in transplant work. He had returned to his first love, which was reconstructive surgery. These pioneering moments usually have many parents and even a little serendipity. It's always important when you're thinking about the celebrated event that it's never just this one snapshot in time.